You said that your main problem is the OCD, that you wash your hands repeatedly or you fear to go out, right? So when we call OCD, there are two main parts. One is obsessive thoughts and compulsive action. So what are your obsessive thoughts? You should make one side the obsessive thoughts and what are the compulsive action you do to come out from that obsessive thoughts, right? So, what is this exposure and prevention therapy for OCD? Exposing to the thoughts or the action. For example, you say that you fear to go out, opening the door so that you get the COVID infection is the main, you get that thought, right? That is the thought what you get. And what do you do to in order to overcome that thought, that anxiety level? So you just come inside and close the door of the house, or you just avoid going out. So this is the preventing action what you do to in order to come out from that anxiety. Or for example, you touch some pen or pencil used by the other person in the house, and you go and wash your hand. That is exposing to the items or the materials what is there used by the common people. And what sort of action you are doing to prevent that anxiety is the preventing action or the compulsive action. You go and wash your hands. That is the compulsive action. So this much you have to understand what exactly is the problem you are going through. Now, what happens in that sort of time is, so yeah, when you get exposed to say that you touched one object which is used by your other person in your home, so what happened at that point of time? You get the thoughts, this obsessive thoughts you get, and then you feel that okay, I touched the pen used by one of my friend or cousin. Your anxiety level increases. You start thinking that you will get COVID infection. You think that I may get this, that, and all. This anxiety level keep on increasing here, right? So next, when it reaches the peak, what happens? When it reaches the peak, it just come like this, and you do some action here in order to come out from that anxiety thought. So what happens when you do this action? Your anxiety levels come to balance and your anxiety slowly decreases. This is what happens in that process. Now, in order to overcome this action, to prevent this action, what you have to do? Because you know that you have a problem and you want to come out from that anxiety and these obsessive thoughts. Let the thoughts be there. Let's move on to the solution. What you can do? You have to understand this graph. What happens when you expose to some thoughts or when you touch the object? Your anxiety level keeps on increasing. At certain point of time, you will feel tired of that anxiety, and then you think you have to do compulsorily some action to come out. There, when you do this action, and slowly your anxiety levels come down, and you become normal. And next, till the next trigger starts, you will be perfectly fine. This is what happens now. What you have to do now is when you get the obsessive thoughts or touch some objects which has been used by someone else in the home, your anxiety levels again start increasing like this. When it reaches the peak, as I said, you have to do nothing here. Do nothing. That is, prevent the action. Just observe for a few minutes. Do nothing here. Don't do any action. Compulsive action of washing hands. Washing hands. No. Don't do. Sit quietly for some time. Observe what that thought process is happening. Don't wash your hands or don't lock your door. Let it happen. Think about that. And if you don't do the action here, then when the next anxiety levels comes, you automatically that anxiety level will not go to this peak. It will stay somewhere here. Then it reduces here. Then it reduces here. So when you don't do the action, what I showed, this phase which is making you more compulsive actions, that phase will get nil and your anxiety level naturally comes down. So this is how the graph is. you have to work on this. This is nothing but the prevention. Exposing to the obsessive thoughts and preventing it. That is nothing but exposure and prevention therapy for OCD. This much you have to understand. And next time what happens when you get the trigger factor? Again, your anxiety levels goes up. If you have followed this prevention, not doing any action at that anxiety period, your next level of anxiety will be only 80%. Then do nothing over here also. Do nothing. Then again, your anxiety levels comes down. This graph will go like this. One fine day, you will be out from OCD. This is how exactly the treatment procedure is. You have to practice this. Take care.